is a fairy tale of love. Thank you.
This is the story about love. When a guy meets a girl in a bar, he sees the girl, he looks at her, and all he wants to say is a great big
hello. Is it me you're looking for?
She looked lovely. The dress that night she was wearing was
gold.
She wasn't looking at it, so he showed her his best dance moves.
What does the fox say? What the fox say?
Every day I'm shuffling.
Hey, you look thirsty. You want a drink? What you want?
Tequila.
What?
Tequila.
Why?
It makes me happy.
Fair enough. The girl looks at the guy and says, I'm sorry, I've got to go to the toilet. Don't go, he says. Please don't go.
Please don't go.
I love this act.
Suddenly, the girl comes back.
I'm so excited. I just can't hide it. I'm about to lose control and I think I like it.
The girl laughs at the guy and says, hey, wanna come back to my place for a coffee? The guy says, hey.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night.
So the guy got with the girl and now they've been together for 45 years.
If I could turn back time.
And that is the fairy tale of love.
Thank you for watching.
Oh no.
Carl's face is awesome.
This is my good friend Passaro. It's a Brazilian word. It means bird.
They call me Third.
Bird.
Third Newton. Look at her.
Miss French.
See. Si. The vixen of Diddley.
It's actually Vicar of Dibley.
You pray for what you want, I'll pray for what I want.
That's funny.
Who the hell is that?
That's Kyle.
He's ugly.
That's enough, you don't... Sorry. But...
That was a matter of time.
You don't tell him he's ugly, huh? You don't do that. Apologise, huh? Tell him you're sorry. I'm sorry you're ugly. No.
You're funny.
I apologise, Carl. I'm sorry.
I love you, Miss French.
Don't say that.
I love her.
Talk to her properly, huh? Engage her in conversation.
How old are you?
No. You don't ask a lady her age.
What year are you born?
No.
I love you. I know you love it. Stop saying it. I love you.
All right, that's enough.
I'm going to sing to her. There's no song. We're not doing a song. Hit the music.
And I will always love you. Yes, I will always love you.
I love Bertie.
Oh.
All right. Am I meant to be here?
Yes.
All right. I didn't mean be here. I meant just...
Yes. What's your name?
My name's Graham. Well, do you want my full name? Or,
yes,
or
what full name.
My full name's Michael Graham Blackledge, but everybody calls me Graham. In fact, I didn't even know I was called Michael until I was about 11, because nobody wanted to tell me. And then it took me a year to figure out how to spell it, because it's an awkward name, isn't it?
You're very likeable.
Very.
Thank you.
It wasn't a joke, I was just giving you a compliment. You're very likeable.
Yeah.
OK, Michael, what are you going to do?
What am I going to do? Yeah. I'm going to play the organ.
Yeah. Yeah, you.
I'm going to play the organ and then I'm going to play and sing whilst playing the organ.
So the organ playing is what you'd like to be doing full time?
The organ playing?
Yes.
Yeah, I like playing the organ, yeah.
Will you play the organ for us now, please?
Yeah.
Good.
Good luck.
Do you say go, or do I just...
Oh. Go!
Sorry.
That was horrific.
Oh, sorry.
Can I tell you why? Because you were smiling at us in this weird way the whole way through.
Oh, right. I can cut the smile
no,
out.
No, you won't. Can I hear you singing and playing the organ together, but without the weird smiling?
Without the weird smile. Shall I just carry on from where I left off?
Yes.
Is that all right?
Smile, Graham. When does the singing start?
It's coming. He said it's coming now. I think I enjoyed more listening to you talk than I did listening to you play. If I'm being honest, but when you actually started doing ba-da-da, I was like, oh, this is nice. But I quite enjoyed you in some weird way.
I'll say that as a compliment before
it
you
is a compliment. It is.
It was hideous. It was. It's like eating vanilla ice cream with a sausage. They don't go together.
Have you ever tried vanilla and sausage?
Have you ever thought of just doing stand-up comedy?
Have I thought about doing stand-up comedy?
Yes, you! We're talking to you!
No, I haven't.
OK, I'm going to kick this off with a no.
Alicia.
About you that I absolutely love. I'm going to say yes.
One no, one
yes, it's down to David Walliams.
You are a very funny man.
Oh, my lip's sticking to me teeth.
David, yes or no?
You know what? I'd love to see you again. It's a yes.
Yeah. I thought I had to get three. But they only have to get...
No, you get two.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, could we have the name of the act, please?
Just James and Ed.
Okay, right, and what's the act?
I'm a ventriloquist for the day.
Okay, and do you think you can win?
Of course I can.
Really?
Well, we're going to give it a good shot. We're going to
okay.
Try.
All right, okay, yeah. Best of luck.
All right then, guys. I'm a little bit nervous about introducing you to Ed because he speaks a bit too much. He gets me in a bit of trouble. But I want you to be nice to him because he's only 12 years old. And he's been under my bed in a box for the last 3 months gathering dust. Hi, Red.
Ooh. Where have you taken me, James? Who are all these people?
I told you this morning we're auditioning.
Oh, I see. There's Alicia Dixon. We're on Strictly Come Dancing.
No, Ed, it's not Strictly. It's Britain's Got Talent.
No, Alicia's on Strictly Come Dancing, James.
I told you this morning, Simon Cowell poached her.
That's so scandalous.
Ed, stop messing about. Come on, we need to get on with our act or we'll get buzzed off.
Okay, who's that on the end?
That, David Walliams. You know David Walliams? He swam the Thames. He did the Channel Sports Relief.
David Walliams?
Not Williams, Walliams. He's like the greatest comic genius of our time.
No.
You do know him. He did come fly with me.
We got coffee, we got cups, we got sugar, we got sweetener, we got gas to make a hot, hot fire, but the Lord decided today would be the day when we'd have no water. So we've got no choice but to close the shop.
So you do know who he is then?
Computer says no. Who's that there?
Baywatch.
David Hasselhoff's back.
It's the sexy one, the one with the boobs.
Are you saying that we're in the same room as Hammer and...
Hammer Electra!
Oh, from Cheaper by the Dozen too. Why didn't you say? Who's the funny-looking one on the end?
That's Simon Cowell. Everyone knows Simon Cowell. He's like the King of England. He wears his trousers up to here.
Yeah, but what's his talent, James?
What's his talent?
Well, does he clean up?
Does he clean up?
Well, does he wash up?
Does he wash up?
Well, does he brush up?
No, he doesn't brush up.
So you're telling me that he does nothing, the boy does nothing? I got a man with two left feet. And when he dances up to the beat, I really think that he should know that his rhythm's go-go. Does he wash up? Never wash up. I don't want to go in the box.
Get back in your box.
I don't want to go in the box.
This is blood.
Call me Bubbles. Everybody does.
Get down, Bubbles.
That wasn't supposed to happen. Alicia.
He's right. That wasn't supposed to be as good as it was.
David?
It was annoyingly really funny.
Hilarious. That was awesome.
Yeah, it was annoyingly good. I wasn't expecting that at all. And your impressions were very, very good. David?
I say yes.
Alicia?
100% yes. Yes!
You got four yeses.
Oh, my God!
Okay. And for my second song, I'd like to... I met this girl. She's just great. This girl I just adore. The problem is, she has much more than I had bargained for. She's got that style. She's got that smile. She's got the walk. She's got the talk. She's got that zing. There's just one thing. She's got a penis. She's got that flair. Knows what to wear. She's got that face. That girlish grace. She's got pizzazz. Too bad she has a penis. Some failure, always some flaw. Ain't that what they call Murphy's Law? But male genitalia, that's where I draw the line. Besides, hers is bigger than mine. My life's a mess, 'cause under that dress, she's got a P-E-N-I-S. Yes.
Thank you very much.
Great job, Ray!
Thank you very much.
Ray.
Yes.
So, Ray, you... So you wrote the song, you said,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Did that happen to you? Is this a true story and you turn it into a song?
Well, actually, something like that happened to a friend of mine. I know those friend of mine things, but this is true, actually.
You have no idea what you just did in my house. My children are all sitting in the audience, and they all will be singing that song later on tomorrow, the next day, the day after. You have no idea. It is a very catchy tune, but I tell them not to say that.
It's a catchy tune. I like to write catchy tunes. They don't write them like that anymore.
Can I tell you something? You know, I'm really thinking you're a breath of fresh air at 84 years old. When you first got up, I was kind of like, oh, this is one of those acts that are a waste of time. I was going to buzz you in this. And then all of a sudden, you kicked in with that brilliant lyric. And you know what? Good for you. You know, you hear 84-year-old guy, you think 84-year-old guys have lost their sense of humor. You've got it in spades. You did a terrific audition.
Some of them have lost everything. So
fantastic.
You
know. Right.
Some even at an earlier age.
Yeah, absolutely.
Mel B.
Ray, you are a naughty, funny, dirty old man.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, dear.
And I loved it. Made me laugh a lot.
Thank you. We need more laughter.
Howie, you were up on your feet.
I love it. Yeah. I'll tell you something. You're funny and witty and personable, and I can't see enough of you. I love you, Mr. Jessel.
Thank you so much.
As well. That's three yeses.
And I'm going to give you four yeses.
Good evening.
How you doing?
Shh.
Why?
Not so loud.
Baby's sleeping.
Oh, you brought... Oh, it's bringing... Oh, you brought...
I'm really sorry. I couldn't find a babysitter. Fantastic last time. Thank you very much.
Why are we whispering?
Now look what you've done. sorry, be right with you.
Hey.
What?
That mirror.
What?
That mirror's not working.
Mirror? That's not a mirror. That's Howie.
Daddy!
No, no. So listen, you go to sleep now.
I want a story.
What?
Story.
What?
I want a story.
No, we haven't got time for the story.
Story.
No, no, we haven't got time.
I want a story.
Okay. Okay. All right, I'm really sorry. If I tell you a quick story, you promise me you go to sleep straight away. This is the story of Little Red Riding Hood.
Red Riding Hood?
Yeah, shh. She was walking through the woods on the way to her granny's house when all of a sudden out jumped a big bad wolf.
Wolf?
Yes, a nasty one with big horrible teeth.
No, don't like it.
No, but it's part of the story.
Don't like that one.
No, but it has to be.
Don't like it.
Okay.
Change it.
All right. Okay, I'll change it. What do you want me to change it to?
Duck.
The thing is with the story, it won't work as a story if it's a duck.
I want a duck.
Okay. Okay. It wasn't a big bad wolf.
No.
It was a big bad, duck.
Big bad duck?
Yeah.
No, fluffy yellow duck.
Little Red Riding Hood was really frightened.
Why?
Well, because she wouldn't be frightened of a fluffy yellow duck, would she?
No.
Hence, you've done it again, and my story doesn't work. You keep doing this to my story.
Doing what?
You keep making me put ducks in them.
Duck!
They don't work as stories when there are ducks in them.
Duck!
What about yesterday's? Goldilocks and the three ducks.
Duck!
Snow White and the seven ducks.
Duck!
Why do you keep saying duck?
Oh! Good finish.
Yeah.
This is fun for the whole family. This is a big family show, and you're a big family act.
How many other puppets have you got?
I have a couple more. There's more to me than what you've seen so far.
Right. Oh.
Oh, yes.
She wants to see your puppets.
No, I don't. Gosh. Well, I just think that your material is really, really clever, and you do make us believe like they're real. They're really two people on the stage. You're very, very good.
You know, you're a cartoon come to life. I felt like I was watching a great cartoon. You and this baby and this dialogue is so fabulous. You're going to be a main contender. I mean, I don't think there's anyone sitting in this room right now who doesn't believe that you're not going to be in the top five.
It was wonderfully orchestrated. The joke telling was great. You made a grown man feel like he was a kid, and I just felt myself just laughing, and I felt joy. And I want that feeling, and I want everybody to feel that feeling of joy. So I love comedy, and I love you, so.
Compliment Marlon on his choice because I feel like we've got a great guy in you. That's such a talent. What a gift you have.
Paul, you are now going straight through to Radio City Music Hall.
Whenever you're ready.
Hey, you can say good evening. You speak English? It's my night. Come on, hey, say something.
No.
What? Why not? It's fantastic. Come on. Sprechen Sie Deutsch?
Yes. Oh my God.
No. Listen, English.
Si.
Spanish.
Oui.
Français.
Okay.
Hey, Wendy, listen to me. You think I am stupid?
Yes.
This is brilliant! I want one!
So, well, you don't want to speak anymore?
No.
Okay. And now?
Oh, yes, I want.
You know how to sing?
No.
What?
Yes, yes, yes.
Good. Okay. Well, we listen to you.
Meow.
It's bow wow, eh? You understand?
Meow. Yeah.
Music, please. We're gonna sing something for you, all right? Okay, don't look at me. Look at the audience, like that. Feelings, come on.
Feelings.
Nothing more.
Nothing
more.
More.
Trying to forget. All together, okay?
No.
Please, come on. It's pretty good talent, okay? All together. Feelings.
Aye, aye.
Feeling.
Oh, my God.
What's her name?
Wendy. Of
Wendy.
Try and listen when they're doing the act.
Well, I'm emotional.
He's waited a long time for this moment. For 9 years, Simon has said he wanted a dog that could meow or sing. And your dog did both those things. I mean, you're making television history here, which is.
Wow. I don't know how she does that, how you taught her to do it, but it was incredible.
Oh, thank you so much.
How does she know the words?
She's very clever.
It's an incredible act, and one we're never going to forget, Mark. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Fantastic act, Mark. Really something special. Right, David.
Well, this is a very easy yes.
It's a yes from me. It's a yes from me.
You've got 4 big fat yeses.
Hello. Nice to meet you. Hello, everyone. Hi.
Hello.
Sorry, bit nervous.
Who are you?
I'm Phil W. Green. I'm 21, and I'm going to be doing comedy impressions. Hooray!
Phil, do you do this full time?
No, I don't, no.
What do you do?
I work at Body Shop at the moment as a customer consultant.
I bet your dream is to be a big international
yes,
star.
Yes, I'd love to be on stage.
Philip, did you bring anyone with you?
So, my friend Christy.
Does she work at Body Shop?
She did, but she's recently left.
Why?
Because she found a better job.
Found a better job!
Sorry!
Where?
She now works at Barrett's, so... Shoes!
I hope he's good after all of this.
Okay, well, look, Philip, you've got roughly 2 minutes. Let's do it.
Okay. Hello, I'm Natalie Cassidy. And today, we're going to be health working out. So everyone put your hands out in front of you, spread your legs, and do some squats. Lie down, the baby, on Martin Fowler's sofa. Isn't that right? Dawn Cotton would be proud, wouldn't she? Ooh, It's so nice to be here on my wee show. And today's guest is absolutely fantastic. You know what? I'm going to meet her. Hello. Oh, thanks for having me, Charlotte. Oh, I'm so nervous. Oh, come on. And then, oh, I was on Go Out of the Jungle recently. Oh my God. I mean, I saw those ones, and I was like, whoa. And then I saw even more ones, and I was like, whoa. And then they tried to make me eat the ones, and I was like, whoa. And I was like, whoa. And I was being sick everywhere. Oh my goodness. Have you seen the bacteria in here? It is awful. Isn't that right, Kim? Oh, my love. Oh, that stinks. Darling, it's me, Louis Spence, dancing. Everyone likes to duck. Come on, duck. Everyone, come on, duck. Everyone, duck, duck, and down, duck, and down, and Spence, duck. Oh, ooh, ooh.
I like him a lot.
The brilliant thing about your act was that you had us laughing before you even did anything.
Oh, thanks, Amanda.
David!
You're like a butch version of me. You're a very, very funny guy. I'd like to see some more of you in the act as well. Because you are hysterically funny as you as well.
Are you sure you're not related to Stacey Solomon?
I wish I was. I've seen her from a distance and I was like, Stacey. But no.
I think you're really funny, lovable.
Do you need a wee?
No. I'm just really nervous. Sorry.
Solomon?
It was like the world record for how many impersonations you can do in 2 minutes. I found it difficult to keep up with some of them. But the ones that were great.
Oh, thanks.
But you are a naturally funny guy.
Oh, thanks.
Slightly bonkers. But I like that.
You're gonna take a boat. David, yes or no?
I'm going to say yes.
It's a yes from me.
Simon?
And we have actually had some good impressionists on the show this year. So you have got some competition. But I am going to say... yes.
Yay! That's four yeses. You're through for the next round.
Thank you so much. It's nice to meet you all. See you soon. Bye-bye.
Thank you very much indeed. How many of you here tonight are ready to enter the land of make-believe? Looks like Howie's already in the land of make-believe, which makes you the perfect person to join me up here on stage. Would you mind? Let's hear it for Howie Mandel, everyone. Yes, thank you. In your own time, Howie. I understand your logic. The longer you take, the shorter my act. I quite understand. Have a seat there, Howie. Tonight, live from Radio City, you are going to become a human ventriloquist dummy. Okay, now all you have to do... all you have to do is keep looking out there, all right? Let me do all the talking, okay? And I've got to say, that's a pretty good fit. By the way, this is Charlie. Are you okay, Charlie?
Yes, thank you.
First of all, we've got to find you a voice, something that matches your physical appearance, something butch, something macho. Are you okay?
Yes, I am.
Well, it shocked me.
It shocked me.
I was only joking. Do you want me to change the voice?
No, I like it.
Okay.
I want to say hello to my fans.
You want to say hello to this lot?
Yes.
Turn to the people on the right, give them a big wave, say hello.
Hello.
Nicely done. Now the people on the left, say hi to them.
Hiya.
And now the people right up the top, give them a big sexy hello.
Hello.
Did you see them waving back?
Yeah, idiots. Now stop touching me.
What?
Get away.
What?
Stop touching me.
What do you mean I'm not touching?
Get away.
Okay, all right. Is that far enough?
Perfect. Hey, how are you doing that?
I've got a little controller in my hand here.
Oh, wow, that's amazing. He's got a controller. He can control me.
Yes, that's right.
Oh, now he can have some fun. I don't want to be a judge.
No.
I want to be an act.
You want to be an act?
Yes. You go and judge me.
You want me to judge you?
Yes. Go and sit in my seat.
I can't sit in your seat.
No, I insist.
Well, if you insist... Hello, fellow judges.
Hi.
It's great to be here. Okay, so I can't believe I'm a judge on America's Got Talent. So, what's your name?
Well, my name is, sorry, I'm a bit nervous.
Don't worry, take your time.
My name is Howie.
Hello. Good evening, Howie. And what are you going to do for us tonight?
Tonight, I want to do my dancing.
Look, you don't have to.
No, I really want to.
Yes.
Okay, so do you have some moves you'd like to show us?
Oh, yes. Let me stand up, first of all. Here I go. Okay, first of all, I'd like to stretch. I'm going to do some stretching. I'll just stretch my arms like this. And my legs like this. Okay, so now to business.
Okay, what are you going to do?
I'm going to show you my twerking. So, I turn around, I put my hands on the seat, and I wiggle my butt.
Is that it?
Oh, yes. Hang on. Let me turn around again.
Yes. Okay. So that was fantastic. Don't make me laugh, though. I can't make you talk when I laugh. So what are you going to do for your performance this evening?
Tonight, I'm going to do some Irish dancing.
Really?
Naked.
I really don't think this is the show for that. So when you're ready, the stage is yours.
Cue the music.
Paul Zerner.